Hey, a pleasant good day, everybody. This is Sports Fanatic News. I'm Joe Boric, and this is going to be the New Year report on the Carolina Hurricanes. I did some of these as quarterly reports. If you want to go back and look at them, they're all in the quarterly reports slash New Year reports playlist on my channel. So if you want to check them out there, I would really appreciate it. And please continue to subscribe down below. But let's get right into it with the Carolina Hurricanes, as they're in a very tough metropolitan division that's very close to the top three, 48 points each for the Capitals and the Rangers. And who is right behind them with 47? None other than the Carolina Hurricanes, and one of the deepest teams formed by Don Waddell and Coach Rod Brind'Amour. One of the deeper teams out there. We already saw, of course, Jack Drury come up and make an immediate impact, as now he's back down kicking butt at the AHL level. We saw Alex Lyon come up and make an immediate impact, their third-string goaltender, former Lehigh Valley Phantom. Love that kid make an impact. Nobody loves him as much as Samantha Wismer, though. And then we have Ian Cole is doing his job, just being the simple, steady veteran defenseman back there. Ethan Bear was a fantastic pickup. Tony D'Angelo has matured. Rod Brind'Amour made him wise. He's pretty much at a points per game, playing fantastic. Slavin is Slavin. You know what you're getting. Brady Shea, they turned into a wizard. Obviously, he was a little bit more offensive with the Rangers, but his defense wasn't as squeaky clean. Now his defense is immaculate, as well as he still has some, gives you some stuff on offense as well. And then Brett Pesce, I've loved his entire career. I think he's one of the most underrated defensemen in the league, because obviously he's one of the more talented and one of the more good, not just physically, but also just at blocking shot and just being defensive of right-handed defensemen in the league. He's a guy that, honestly, looking at hindsight's 2020, but probably would have been better for my Flyers to get than Ryan Ellis if you could have got somebody in trade, but obviously they didn't end up moving him, as he's been in trade rumors forever. As somebody to get move on from, but they've been able to find a way to keep him, and that's the wise thing to do. I would never get rid of Brett Pesce. He's one of the most underrated defensemen in the league. Rookie Seth Jarvis is playing fantastic. So the reason why the Hurricanes are doing well is, I mean, well, one, goaltending. Frederick Anderson's one of the best goaltenders in the league. 192, 929, number one, numero uno, is defense and goaltending. And you knew this team, even coming in, was still going to have a good defense. Gardner, who's been banged up, is an afterthought anyway on the defense. Ian Cole stepped in as a very good veteran. Ethan Bear was a brilliant pickup, like I said. Brady Shea, they turned into a very good two-way defenseman. Brett Pesce is the most underrated, one of the most underrated, I should say, in the league. Tony D'Angelo is back to being very good and actually is having his best defensive season as well. Not calling him a great defensive defenseman, but I'm just saying he's actually looking all right. And then Jacob Slavin's Jacob Slavin. And then Annie Ron is doing what you would want as a backup, 235, 908. So you have a good backup as long as he can stay healthy. And then you have Frederick Anderson as well as Alex Lyon, who's a good third-string goaltender. And Jack Drury, who looked good. Josh Levo's obviously a veteran who's looked very good in the minors. So you can call him up whenever you need him. Paul Dorowski, who's won the player of the month in the minors. So he's a guy that's been good. I think it was the player of the month. It's either the player of the week or the player of the month. I mix them up because I do so much different content on each of those things. But either way, he's been fantastic at the AHL level. So you can use him if needed. But obviously this team is fueled by just how good their goaltending and defense system, in-your-face aggressive system, is with Rod Brind'Amour. And then obviously on the offensive side, it's fueled by the leader of them all, Sebastian Aho, on that offense that they obviously have until 2024 for the time being, as well as the rest of that first line in Teuvo Teravainen, who they have the 2024, and then Nito Niederreiter, who's playing good for them, who's a UFA after this year, so it's going to be interesting if they can find the cheddar to keep him, because also Jesperi Kotkaniemi, who's at a 0.5 points per game pretty much right now, playing all right in his first season with the Hurricanes, is obviously a RFA at the end of this season, as well as Marty Nikas. So it will be interesting to see what these teams are able to do here with their cap situation. As I said, for some other teams, the same goes for the Carolina Hurricanes, what they're going to be able to do with the UFA of Nino Niederreiter, the RFA of Jesperi Kotkaniemi, RFA, well, Stevie Lorenz is not going to get that much money. He's just a very good fourth-line player. Marty Nikas is an RFA, though, who will get good money. So it's going to be interesting to see what's going to happen here with him and his value, because I think that's going to push out being able to keep Nino Niederreiter. But we'll have to see. The Hurricanes, I wouldn't worry about it, though, too much, fans, because, yeah, Niederreiter's a good player, but they're so good at replacing players, Don Waddle and Rob Brind'Amour, that they'll have somebody come in. And Jack Drury already played very well, so you already have a player you can slot in there, number one, to play on the wing or play at center and then move somebody else to the wing. So there's already options there. Dominic Bulk is in the minors as well, so you have different guys. Blake Murray's a fun player. So you have different guys that could make an impact, and then you would just be moving somebody else down the lineup so those guys can be on the third line, what have you. Because it's going to be interesting, because Kotkaniemi's not going to be cheap. He'll probably get a pay cut from what he's getting paid right now if he keeps producing at the level he is right now and does an uptick. But he's not going to be cheap. Obviously, Nakis isn't going to be cheap. So, I mean, it's going to be interesting to see what they're going to be able to do, because Marty Nakis is is a tough one, because I think he's going to get paid probably at least 5'7". I would have to guess with the way that he plays and how good of a two-way game he plays. But we'll have to see going forward. But all in all, this has been a fantastic season with Carolina Hurricanes. I say they are a cup contender because, number one, like I said, their defense and goaltending is stellar. And then their offense is absolutely great as well. And they're deeper. They have Podorowski. They have Drury. They have Balk if they have to call up other guys as well. Lyon, not a bad third-string goaltender. Aho, Niederreiter, and Tiiravainen is a very good first line, one of the best in the league. Svechnikov, Trocheck, and Jesper Vass is a very solid second line as well. You might want to get a different forward potentially to add a little bit to the forward depth if Kotkaniemi doesn't pick up his 0.5 points per game pace. I wouldn't be surprised if they try to add somebody that expires at the end of the year, like maybe Carolina will try to find a way to fit in Phil Kessel just to add more offense to their team, since Kotkaniemi, I don't think, is producing to the offensive level they hope. All in all, he's not having a terrible season, but he's not producing to the utmost level I think that they were hoping they were going to get out of him. So that wouldn't shock me. But this team doesn't have to do much. They're already a cup contender. Great goaltending, great offense, and just a great overall team that's also gone through some COVID protocol and having key guys out and have got through it. They've been a team that whenever they've had guys out, they've been able to battle through it and get through it. Right now, Brandon Smith, who has played 18 games and played fairly well for this team, another veteran D-man, is out as well. So I hope everybody enjoyed this video to the New Year report of the Carolina Hurricanes. This team is definitely a cup contender because of, as I said, great goaltending, great defense, and then you have great lines as a whole. You have good depth. I wouldn't be surprised if, say, a guy like Vast or Kotkaniemi doesn't pick up their offensive output if they don't try to add a guy that's on a one-year expiring contract just to add a little bit more offense there to the team. But that would be the only thing. They don't need it. But obviously, teams that can get more embarrassment or riches that are cup contenders always do try to add that if they can get it for a value that they think is fair. So I wouldn't be surprised if Carolina is a team looking to do that. But peace out, everybody. Stay safe. Enjoy your new year and enjoy the hockey. Please continue to subscribe down below if you enjoy the content. Hope you enjoyed the Carolina Hurricanes New Year report. Stay tuned for the Colorado Avalanche New Year report coming up.